This is Piers Morgan Live. Robert Zimmerman Jr., the brother of the man who shot Trayvon Martin, is here to explain this, a shocking tweet that he sent out that a lot of people are calling racist, comparing Dr. DeMarcus Elkins, the 17-year-old charged with shooting Sherry West Baby, with Trayvon Martin, both teens making an obscene gesture. And Zimmerman added the caption, quote, "A picture speaks a thousand words. Any questions?" Unquote. Robert Zimmerman Jr. joins me now exclusively. Robert, I've spoken to you a number of times in the last year. I read all the tweets that you sent carefully, and there's no doubt they were incendiary. And I want to draw in particular attention to two of them. One is one that you said here, alleged FB pics of 30-month-old Antonio Santiago's alleged killer and Trayvon Martin, the two pictures we saw side by side, hashtag uncanny. The second one says, liberal media should ask if what these two black teens did to a woman and a baby is the reason people think blacks might be risky.
Right.
Now, the first one I thought was very controversial. The second one, if I'm blatantly honest with you, I thought was bordering on outright racism.
Right.
It seemed to me that what you were saying was, this is why young blacks are risky. Right. In other words, that is why my brother George did what he did to Trayvon Martin.
Yeah, certainly that's one way to read it. And that seems to be the way that a lot of people have interpreted it. And I don't think Twitter is the place to make points about what you recall a year ago, because the recollections that I have or that we have as a family specifically are very different than what can be portrayed in 140 characters. Now, I realize those were controversial and offensive, and I did publicly apologize for them. I don't think it was the right thing to do that way. One of the point about the pictures was the larger point on the media and their honesty in portraying the person who encountered my brother February 26. We've been led to believe that it's a junior high school aged person because of the pictures, the way he's portrayed.
Well, he was 17.
Well, we'll never interview Trayvon Martin. We'll never see Trayvon Martin, but we have...
You didn't dispute he was 17.
No, of course not, Pierce. I'm not gonna...
So you're talking about a young 17-year-old boy who had gone from his father's house to buy some Skittles from a store.
Okay, so
and
now
was returning.
We're back to the Skittles from the store. Here, let me
explain. We're not back to that, but the reason why I want to take you back to that is that when you say that what these two black teens did to a woman and a baby, they shot the baby in the head, is the allegation that they've been charged with.
Right.
A more gruesome crime would be hard to imagine. You are likening this to Trayvon Martin, who was unarmed.
Well, let me...
He didn't even have a gun on it.
Let me get back to the first tweet. What I'm saying is, and again, I understand it's controversial and I apologize for it, and I'm sincere about that. I shouldn't have done it this way. And I don't dispute he was 17. I understand that. What I'm saying is, yeah, he was 17, and he chose to portray himself by his own hand in a certain way.